while I'm live.
Hello?
Hello? Hello? Hello? Hello? Bingo. It's working. All right, so now what I want to do is I want to turn down the music. So what I can do, I don't mind if it's playing. I just want to turn it down so that's below my voice. Decibels below my voice. I do take some vitamins. And I was able to get somebody to help me be able to get them. Because I'm unemployed. Let's talk about that. What does unemployed actually mean? If you're making money from posting videos, then you're employed. If you're making money selling stuff in a WooCommerce e-store, you're employed. You make money uploading designs on products in Redbubble and somebody buys those products, you're employed. Maybe part-time, full-time, whatever, but you're employed. So to say we're unemployed is really tough now after COVID started. I'm afraid to even post this video because I'm only helping the government by posting it. But they're so slow. Government is so behind. How ironic is it that the very entities who control our daily life does not have a clue, because they don't live that daily life. I don't know. Government entities are baffling. Day and age of saying, well, government can do this for me or that for me. Are really changing. I know, it's not because of Trump. Not because of Biden. Not because of Bush. Not because of anybody. Specific. really is changing because of our individual way of changing. Whether you vote or don't vote, you control how government regulates anything. If you live in that regulation, if you use a system that is part of that regulation, man, I just put yolk on that. Then you are part of manipulating society. You're part of manipulating the rules that are imposed upon other people that you don't even know. And now, today, you're part of the meaning of unemployment. It has a whole new meaning. And the government does not know what that means. They do not know. COVID has twisted everything. Because before COVID, within 30 days, maybe you went to XYZ job, and then you got paid within that 30 days to pay 1, 2, 3 rent, right? Or electric, or internet service, or food industry. All the numbers in the big accounting systems everywhere went all of these places, and they came from different places. Today, all those numbers in the accounting system come from a different place. Everybody's avoiding the elephant in the room. Right there in the spotlight. But they're not to blame. They've only done what we've been doing for a couple hundred years now. Whatever. You know, I mean, every person who is alive today who is doing something inside society, who is influencing a company, influencing a family member, what to buy, how to analyze information, how to trust someone, all this stuff, all these people that are alive today doing all these things, have never, ever, 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 ever lived inside of any pandemic situation where everything is shut down like that. Every complete system everywhere shut off. I mean, what a shock. Whew. Every piece of government is hoarding as much money as they can hang on to because they're insecure. They're insecure. They have never been through this, and they're insecure about it. they want to tell me I'm employed or unemployed or this or that, or try to impose laws on me that existed before COVID, I like, yeah, what? No, you need to relate to what is happening right now, not before COVID. Our life is not ever going to be exactly the same as it was before COVID. I don't care what commercial you put out there. It's not. It's not. The whole system is huge. There are too many variables, in too many places, and too many people. I mean, there's just too much. There's no way it's ever going to be the same it was before COVID. I might wear a mask the rest of my life. I don't know. I might never leave this room for another year. I don't know. It all depends on what other people do. The government's not going to tell me I have to go somewhere. Because they're wrong. They're not protecting me. They're not showing me how they're going to provide any protection whatsoever when people are out there shooting people and doing whatever they're doing. I'm not going to feel protected. Running people over. The police were so scared last year that they weren't anywhere to be seen all the way to work every day when I was working. I would drive to work when I had a car and I was working. Not one police officer was anywhere. Unless you saw like five or six or something at one scene of something going on. But nobody was monitoring the traffic. Nobody was stopping any cars. People were railroading all over me. I had to constantly be extremely aware of traffic around me, because they were going to run me over if I wasn't. I mean, it was messy. People don't care. Or, you know, they're just not going crazy with the whole situation. So, government, Republicans, keep trying to enforce on me to go out there in the craziness where they will not protect me. If I do, they want me to go out there and I don't know what they want me to do. Places are closed. What am I going to do? I can't walk into an office. What am I going to do? Where am I going to go? I don't know what's open, what's not open. I don't have money to go out there. Am I going to, buy a bus ticket, wear a mask, go into an office building and see if there's an office open or something? What am I going to do? How am I going to apply for work that relates to my field? I don't have any way of doing that. I have to do it online. Alright, so I have to do it online. So then what? Okay. Let's see, offices are closed. I can't walk into an office and say, are you hiring for IT? Are you hiring for customer service agents? Are you hiring for, I can't walk into anything and apply anywhere. unless it's probably places that, you know, even if it is places that I can, I don't know where I can go or where I can't go, and I have to use the bus. I don't have a car now. How am I going to choose where to go apply and where not to apply? What if they're not open? What if they're only open a couple hours a day? What if they don't allow the public to come inside the building or come inside the office? Or, I mean, what, we don't know. We don't know any of these little itty-bitty details. That's like, there's somebody online who travels a lot. And loves Disneyland, right? Disney World or whatever. And shut down. Later, they go, well, they're open. No, not really. They're not really open. Right? It's not. It's not ever going to be the same as before COVID-19. No, they're not open. They're running with a million rules. All of it makes sense, but the point is, you know, you can't just automatically go there and think that they're open when they're not actually open. Like, there's one area of a bunch of things in Universal Studios, I think it was, that was closed. So one section of something was open, another section was totally closed. And you don't know that until after you get there. So they trick you to spend your money on a plane ticket, accommodations, getting in the park, the whole bit. Where you might only be able to do it like once every 5 years or who knows, especially now. When you can afford to do what? Oh, well, this section is closed. I don't want to make all my accommodations to go to this place if all of this is closed. You only let me go here, but you don't let me go there. This is open and this is closed. And no, open the whole park or don't open the park. You know? That's manipulating and bait and switch and lying to people. Just so you can get their money. Because you're Disneyland and Disney World and, you know, you want to get their money to pay government whatever that comes out of the taxes that employees pay and stuff and Social Security system and blah, 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 blah. It all goes back to the same thing. Well, we have vaccines now, so we can, you know, pretend like everything's open and get everybody's money. And then we can tell them they have to go look for a job by themselves on their own. We're not going to be there to protect them because we don't want the, you know, variant. The companies can handle protecting themselves and they'll call the police if they have a problem. Right. You know, it's just crazy. So, So what I'm going to do right now, what am I going to do? Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to employ myself to do a service for all the people out there who need it. Hopefully will find me. Oh, what's this? And let's see what we got. Airway opening sound device. Okay. What do we got? So we go into edit, preferences. Where are you? Uh-oh. Oh no, where are you? Yep. Task manager. Oh, come on. OBS is crewing with me. I have a beefed up system. Don't be messing with me. Alright, we're going to cut off Audacity. Look at this. OBS. We're only at 27% here. Very high power usage. I gotta have some air. Air. Basing it on old laws and rules that were going on before COVID. I have to do things based on how things work among millions of people after COVID. I can't do anything. Laws before COVID. Not happening. Because those situations are not going on right now. You know, our governor. So our governor, he did a great job. Yep. He, made sure the vaccine was available. He made sure and gave everybody updates. Blah, 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 blah. But then the lieutenant governor, you know, he was in charge of double checking how unemployment was going and all that stuff, and making sure that people had access to their unemployment, had access to, jobs and so forth. Well, I'm going to shut this light off. Young white male lieutenant governor might be smart, good looking, or whatever, but is not in touch with reality. It's not totally his fault, but yet he's responsible by rules of law to be in charge of helping millions of people. Be in charge of how the laws are interpreted at the unemployment office, and da 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 da, and what jobs are available, and what systems connect with what systems to do what for what people, and you know, I mean, he's in charge of all this stuff, whatever it is. But he doesn't have a clue. Now, I really would respect them more in government if they was to come out and say, this is all new, the media is going to change what I had to say in the wrong context, but I'm going to say it anyway. I'm working with things as they come because it's a whole new situation. We will change as we need to in order to work with however way things change. I mean, the government needs to be accountable, be transparent, explain that they understand what's going on, not act like they're stupid and don't know anything, and not act like it's everything's fine now because the vaccine's there. No, it's not fine now. No, nothing is going to be automatically fixed. Nothing's going to automatically be the same. Even if you go to a concert, there's going to be sections of the concert area that's closed, and you're going to think it's open. You know, I mean, there's things that go on that's going to be different. You think it's going to be one way, and you're going to go there, and it's going to be something else. Nothing's going to be exactly the same. So, and then if we ask about it, you know, like, don't treat me like I'm an idiot or stupid or in some negative way because I ask, well, why is this not open, or, you know, things like that. You know, why'd you say that you were open when you're not open, and you just took my money and you're not going to give me my money back? You know, you're just going to tell me, well, this is closed, but that's okay. Go do that. You know what I mean? If I'm a customers are right. Customers are the ones that are going to be having to handle all this stuff. What is this? I don't care. Just give it to me. Yes, okay. All right, file new. Beep, 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 beep. Okay, we'll just save project and then delete there, close it. All right. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. Oh, let's see. Needs attention. Ambient. I get the A's and the E's and the E and the NT sometimes all kind of mixed up in my head. Look at that later. We're going to close it and work with one file at a time. Now, I'm going to open. Ah, here we go. So we're going to open, let me see. Glacier. Let's find out what that is. Alright. Oh, I gotta close. Whoa. Yeah. Okay, I gotta close this. What is this? Mm-hmm. library in this one. If I do this, will it close? Audio inputs.